secure. Move in and take positions. Quiet. Did you hear that? This is Lee. Give me status. Always clear. There's nothing here, Sam. What the hell? Son of a bitch! Lee, I'm swinging around landing.
Thank you. Thank you. can't believe someone's alive there. You must help me. Time is critical. My name is Richard. Dr. Richard Myers. And I believe I'm the last one alive from my team. I was working with the engineers there before the connection was lost. I don't know what happened to them. But without your help, we may all die. I hope I can count on you. Here's the situation. We were conducting bi-dimensional tests before the attack, and I've lost control of the communication relays. And now we have a functional teleporter still active in the other dimension. And if it's not destroyed, those creatures may be able to use it to reach as far as Earth. You've got to help me. I've done everything I can here, but I don't have enough power to activate the teleporter on this side. The engineers were working with me to redirect auxiliary power from NPRO straight to Exus Labs. But now, looks like you're the only one that can help. I'll upload the array instructions to the SSD at your console. There. Take the SSD and find the main power station in Sector 2. Just plug it into the main terminal and I'll contact you there. There's very little time. Please hurry.
This is the audio log of Chief Alan Rhodes, October 12, 2145. Well, we made significant progress with the field coupler this week. If my calculations are correct, this should provide a considerable boost to the converter's output. I just wish Myers wasn't so damn pushy about this project of his. Well, to be fair, it's actually Betruger's project. Myers is just trying to follow orders and do his job. Anyhow, what we are doing is extremely complex and requires us to be firing on all cylinders. Expanding all of the transference data from Delta has been a very difficult process. What he's proposing requires the full use of a single grid array. I'm just glad we have the entire auxiliary unit to work with. My hope is, within the next few weeks, we will be able to prime the main array in parallel and have the auxiliary working at special capacity for folks over at Exus Labs. And, I think that's all I've got for now. Alan Rhodes, signing off. Alan Rhodes, November 15, 2145. The situation here in Sector 1 is bad. Shortly after getting the auxiliary grid synced with the main array, we experienced a huge power surge. And the output readings are nominal, which leads me to conclude that it's not the auxiliary core. It sounds like a problem with the main array. Regardless, I started hearing screams and gunfire over one of the channels just before our communications went down. Well, we have been trying desperately to get in touch with Myers over in Exus to see what he knows. Several of my technicians have not reported back yet, and my senior technician described a bloodbath near a coolant transfer zone. Following that transmission, his radio went dead, and I've not heard from him since. A few of my other technicians reported seeing strange creatures appearing out of thin air, and none of them have reported back yet. The rest of my team and myself, we just barricaded ourselves into a control room here in Sector 1, and we will continue trying to get communications working, but I don't know how much longer we can stay here. I'll update soon. That's Chief Rhodes signing off.
Pistachios. Chris Vargas, November 5th, 2145. Our initial testing on the primary alignment module indicated excessive stress fracturing. I immediately ordered the team to discontinue the tests, and they've been working around the clock to repair the damaged module. Testing will resume once the unit's back online, and I'm pretty confident we'll be ready for next week's load tests for Chief Rhodes. I have also been asked to help Rhodes with the number crunching going on with the transfer data, which I hope to be finished with soon, provided interruptions are at a minimum. Interruptions, like the one earlier this week when Dave Voss, our security officer, insisted I change the code yet again for the cabinet displaying the shotgun my brother sent to me. It's not like I actually used the damn thing. I don't know, maybe the guy is just anal about code regulations. Personally, I heard he failed the Marine entrance exams and resents being relegated to security officer. I sent an email off to the guy with the new code. Vargas, signing off.
Please insert SSD drive accepted. Stand by.
Excellent work, Marie. I'm getting a link to the SSD drive. The computer's showing that the auxiliary power unit isn't coming online. And it looks like you'll need to prime the flow systems. If you haven't already found one, there should be an ionized plasma levitator nearby. Some of the techs call it a grabber gun. Don't worry, this is a common problem with these systems. You should be able to extract plasma from a working conduit and force it into the non-working one. That should be sufficient to prime the unit. One moment. I'll open the shielding. There. The shield should be open.
Here.
Warning. Mobile security lockdown is in effect. Service sublevel access is restricted.
Thank you.
sub-level access for authorized personnel permitted.
Thank you.
where the future is now.
This is Nasser Adil, security chief for the Exis Labs facility. Log entry November 3, 2145. We are seeing an increasing level of random and unexplained violence by Exis staff. The first incident occurred on October 13, 2145 at the Exis surface tunnel. One of the construction workers, Bill Sanders, was offloading a shipment of steel supports when the procurement manager stopped him. In a heated conversation that followed, Sanders grabbed the nearby pickaxe. Luckily, he generated a sizable crowd. When the later, waking in the holding cell. Since that event, we have seen arguments progress more and more from heated shouting matches straight into outright brawls. The antagonists in these incidents all display the same conditions, as if they were suddenly possessed by violent anger, and then afterwards returned to normal. We have only one serious life-threatening case so far, where engineer Leon Powell was stabbed multiple times. I fear this is not the worst of our troubles, and have requested additional security personnel posted at critical junctions. To assist any immediate medical need, I have resupplied storage cabinet 965 with the accompanying code of 428. Sergeant Nasser Adil out. Nasser Adil, personal log dated November 12th, 2145. I have just received word from Central Authority that the UIC representative, Counselor Elliot Swan, will be arriving in a few days from Earth. The report states he will be reviewing all sectors of Mars City, including Exis Labs. I'm not sure that's a good idea in light of the recent events we've had here. The final assaults that seem to plague Exis Labs have caused the civilian staff to be pretty wary. Now, to top it all off, missing weapons. The cabinets in the security checkpoints were fully stocked 2 days ago, and now half the weapons are gone. I don't know how this situation occurred, but my Marines swear no one has access to the cabinet except for them. I've ruled out those assigned to me and other security personnel, but I can't figure out who else has those codes. To sum up, this is a bad situation. The worst. My recent request for more money than the Exis Labs was denied. It seems other sectors of Mars City are stretched thin, and the small reserves at the base are already allocated. I need to have faith in my current detachment of Marines that they will turn things around. I'll talk to Central again and see if Counselor Swan can bypass Exis. The last thing I want is some staff worker with a sudden episode of dementia murdering a VIP. I'm having enough problems trying to keep everyone here from killing each other. Sergeant Nasir Adil, signing off.
With all those things out there. Look, we don't have much time. These creatures are spreading throughout the base, and if we don't act quickly, all could be lost. I understand you have a lot of questions, but I can't answer them right now. All I can say is we need to get the teleporter in the next chamber working. But to do that, I need you to find a plasma inducer for the stabilizer bank. There's one in engineering. Now, if you head through the service tunnel, you can reach it. I'll unlock some doors. There. That will give you the necessary clearance. Now, please, get the inducer and hurry back. We don't have a lot of time. Please hurry.
Folsom, construction supervisor for the Exus Labs facility. We recently reached substantial completion on the facility's engineering sector and began work on the environmental systems sector early. At this rate, we should be able to impress the big boys up at Central Authority and score our completion bonuses. Last week, I reviewed the construction documents and found another item where we can cut costs. My glass subcontractor mentioned the Moxum pressure seals for the exterior windows can be replaced with much cheaper Mixum seals. I submitted the alternative material selection to the base architect for review. On our Tuesday progress meeting, he argued the Mixum seals aren't up to spec. He complained that those seals are inferior and could cause air leaks or glass blowout. The hell's he know? Guess what? I was building shit before he was born. Anyway, I managed to get the Mixom seals ordered. I bypassed the architect and talked directly to corporate. I shelled in the savings and that sealed the deal. We'll be installing the exterior windows in environmental in a week and he will never know the difference. I'm so convinced the glass and seals will hold up that I'm gonna take a rocket launcher and test it on those windows. Maybe. That shit, a stupid architect. Pulls him out!
Bernice Tooley, Operations Coordinator stationed in Exus Labs. I would like to file my third formal complaint to Central Authority about the problems with the work environment here in Exus. It has become increasingly difficult to be productive while construction is going on throughout the facility. The construction workers are rude, lack common courtesies, and are overtly sexist. They use our office space as an unauthorized shortcut and track dirt and debris as a result. In addition to their mess, they insist on drilling and hammering during our core staff hours. Some of them have repeatedly made inappropriate comments that clearly fall under sexual harassment. When I approached the construction supervisor to remedy the situation, he told me in no uncertain terms to mind my own business. Actually, his exact words were, "Don't worry your pretty little head about it." We are already on edge with the unexplained events occurring around the facility, and to add this insult to our tight schedule is too much to bear. If I cannot persuade Central Authority to take this complaint seriously, I'd like to remind them of Section 20, Paragraph 9 of UAC's Facility Regulations Code. It clearly states our employee rights, and we do not need this nonsense. I suggest you reprimand the individuals responsible and take adequate measures to ensure that it doesn't happen again. Do not make me log additional complaints. Bernice Tooley, signing off. I hope this thing's working. Something is happening here, and no one knows what's going on. The power is going crazy. We can't communicate with Central Administration, and I've heard something... something like screams. I don't know. It was so disturbing. Okay, my assistant left me, and I'm all alone here.
Excellent. You're back. The inducer is working perfectly, and the teleporter is ready for transport. Here's the situation. There's a teleporter outpost in the other dimension, and it's still operational. It's very powerful, and it has a range that could lead those demons all the way to Earth. I would disable it myself, but it requires two people to do it. One person at the outpost to initiate the teleporter, and another person here to transmit a power surge to destroy it. I know it's a lot to ask, but you'll need to go to the other dimension, find the remote outpost, and initiate the startup sequence. You're our only hope of defeating this evil. I've got the teleporter ready to go. All you need to do is go into the chamber and initiate the sequence. I'll handle the rest from here. But before you go, I want to give you my personal account of what happened here. It explains everything. The events, teleporter, how the madness started, everything. It's over there on the console. Please take it. The world needs to know the truth. And good luck.
Decontamination process started. Decontamination.
I have the teleporter sequence already configured. Just activate the main console. When you reach the outpost, I'll be able to communicate with you. Good luck.
My name is Dr. Richard Myers, and I'm a research specialist stationed in Nexus Labs. I don't know who'll be hearing this, but I wanted to alert someone of the disaster at Mars City. What has been unleashed across this base is an unimaginable evil, and we only have a slight chance of stopping it. The research I participated in was the next step in teleportation. To give context to my research, subjects. destinations on this new dimensional plane. The expedition team's people are...
Thank you.
Okay, Marine. I'm receiving your signal from the communication relay. The teleport is warming up. It can only take a few minutes to get to full power. Then I'll be prepared to search and destroy. Watch your back. I'm seeing disruption from the energy waves. Marine, there are things moving your way. Look out!
Nice work, Marine.